body. This is the body, almost last layer, sixth layer. But the energy from this body expresses itself as a pleasure. Whenever the energy is released from this body, you feel pleasure. You feel pleasure. You feel joy. But it is a very deep layer, that is why you feel very less. Naturally. That's why you feel very less. Because when it comes through the pain layer, always the pleasure layer will have a coating of pain. Either you will have the feeling that when it will disappear, it may disappear, or the guilt. It comes from the cosmic layer, from the pleasure layer, it travels to the pain layer, from there to guilt layer, from there it comes out. That's why your joys and pleasures are so much contaminated. Anyhow, let us work on it. Start the moments of joy. Remember, maybe for your birthday, third birthday, second birthday, the gifts have made you joyful. Bliss, whatever moments of ecstasy, joy, when you are really had a beautiful, blissful moments with your wife or husband, with your kids. Remember the major moments.
Swami, you want us to go chronologically from when we are babies or?
Yes, better chronologically. Then only you will remember.
Swamiji, another problem. When we go back home from here, like I went home yesterday, I could see that I was feeling low in energy after we danced here. Then I went back home so much high energy for no, like 2-3 hours, no sleep.
But even if you sleep less, you will not feel tired.
No, not tired, but so much energy.
When you wait here, yes. When you wait and learn something, that's totally different. The word Upanishad means waiting for master, sitting for master. That is what is Upanishad. And you know, there is a Zen story, just by sitting for master, people become enlightened. So many. Sitting for the master is a great moment. But here master is sitting for the disciple. That is why I am becoming more and more enlightened.
Yes, the mental body has three sub-layers. The first one is prana
layer.
And the second
one you can call it as a mind. Third one is the common collective mind. See that when you go to the third one, not only your thoughts, the thoughts of others also affects you. You understand? See, you have two levels of thoughts. For your thought which comes from you, the thoughts which you respond to others. But only two you can work, third you can't do anything. It's something to do with others.
So the technique that we did...
That's enough.
For mental body that covers all the three subjects.
Yes. No, third layer cannot do anything. Only others can do anything. Second, first, only two layers are covered. Pran and the mind.
What you get affected by others' thought process.
See, you can safeguard yourself, when you transform yourself, naturally your surrounding changes. That much only can be done.
In addition to the Maha Mantra, you felt that husband and wife can do together. So we just had a doubt that does only the positive energy transmute or the negative?
You see one thing, whenever energy circulates, it becomes positive. Even if it is a drainage water, when it is circulated or when it flows, it will become a river. As long as it is a pool, even if it is a good water, it will become negative energy. If it starts circulating, even if it is negative energy, it will become positive energy. Alright, now we will start. Anybody? They can share a few of their joyful moments, then you will enter into meditation. Because it's a very highly powerful technique.
I have a question about the last meditation. When we go in, when the healing started, all of a sudden I saw people came up to me, like first family, and the people I didn't even know, people I don't even like from work. rest and then the ocean, and all the scenes came up, and it was just really
amazing.
Yeah.
You are the skin, this body which you have is the physical body, Gova. The other bodies you do not know at all. Actually, the etheric body is beyond your body. There are one or two layers, neither it is inside nor it is outside. The inside-outside concept itself you have to forget. In that layer it is there. You understand? The very idea that inside-outside will disappear. Only then you can understand where that body is there. So, you can't put it in that way. You can't figure it out in that way. Yes?
After the last day of speed, I had a great experience then. And I travel a lot, so I'm on the airplane all the time. And I usually don't even sit by the window. I've seen the window view so many times. But that one time I was coming back from Chicago when I came to the second ASP. And I was sitting by the window, and I could see the sun and the clouds and we were seeing the mountains, and it was the most beautiful experience I've ever seen. It was like the divine and all of those things that I had seen so many times before and never seen.
Mind gives gap sometimes when you see the nature. 1,000 times you may see, but at some one time it will give gap. That's what it becomes an unforgettable memory. I'll explain one incident from my life the same way, before enlightenment. Of course, after enlightenment, every moment is joy only. Before enlightenment, I was walking from Amarkantak to Narmada, Amarkantak to Omkareshwar. It's 800 kilometer from Amarkantak to Omkareshwar. Thick jungle, thick forest. River is flowing in between the two marble hillocks. Both hillocks are total marbles, the marble stone. Between that, Narmada is flowing. Narmada is running. Such beautiful place. And full moon day. It is the full moon day. Maybe Purnima or one day earlier or after Purnima. But full moon. Night I am just walking with a stick in the hand, rolling the stick and singing and walking. I was at one point, like this, you see the hills actually go up and come down. River flows only in the same way. Just near the river I was walking. Suddenly I saw a cliff. I was getting down from one small valley. When I got down from the valley, suddenly I saw a big cliff. When I raised my head, I saw both sides big hillocks shining in the full moon. Because white color, marble color, shining in the moon, and the Narmada is very smoothly, beautifully flowing with a mild sound. And I saw the both hillocks are bridged. There's a connection. It's not looking like a bridge also, it's a connection. Little bit near I went and saw if the whole thing is honeycomb.
Wow.
The honeycomb. Honeycomb, at least I can say 400 feet. When I saw just one moment, my mind gave gap. Still now I could see that moment, so ecstatic. I can remember that moment. So joyful. I think at least between me and the honeycomb, there must be some 500, 600 feet. I have no idea. But above that, the both hillocks are joined. Just on the both things are just joined. Just for a moment, the mind gave gap. Whenever you disappear into the nature, this happens. It was ecstatic moment. So compared to that beauty, Taj Mahal or other things are nothing. Of course, Himalayas.
Highest joy really happens in awfully small things.
Mm, that's true. That's when your mind gives gap.
Every moment I spent with you is very joyous. But the most joyous, I would say, is by your grace, I've had moments to spend with you. But the most joyous was when you gave us a surprise and told us that you're going to come and visit our home. For all those who don't know, he had promised to come to place, and on that day he was kind of tired and he couldn't make it, and we were very disappointed. And but then he consoled us, saying that you know, he's going to be with us. His physical presence is not necessary, but we still being, you know, normal human beings, we still think that, okay, that's on Swamiji's level, he says that, you know what, and that, hey, we are with you, okay, but, you know, we still want that physical presence. And we were kind of disappointed, and I kind of broke down. And one thing I would like to share with you all, when he says that he is with you, he really means it, and he has proved it to us. We were fortunate enough to get that. Wherein the very next day, we got consoled and we said, okay, Swamiji is, you know, he said he's with us because we have faith in him, we have trust in him. And but in spite of that, our minds were kind of saying that, you know, he is God, he is a Swamiji, he's got tremendous powers. So if he's got power, let him prove it to us. You know, we have so much of faith in him. He's God, but, you know, some way, just prove it to us that, you know, you're with me, you're with us. And you wouldn't believe it. The very next day, I got a call from somebody I didn't even know. And their father from Coimbatore, where I didn't have any relatives, I don't know anybody there, called me. And our father called their son in Detroit. And then that person called me and told me that, you know what, your name has been referred to us, and we want you to, we have our, his brother actually was suffering from stroke and memory loss, and he wanted to meet Swamiji, and he contacted me. And from last August when I met Swamiji, from then till today, nobody has called, till that day, nobody had called asking for, you know, asking me that, or nor has anybody called after that. So it's just one incident. And this, I don't know who it is. And the worst part is, how did they get my name? How did they know my number? How did they know anything at all? And if they had contacted somebody in Bangalore, you know, Swamiji comes with this troop. All his PRO and security, everybody is in LA. There are so many healers in LA. They could have contacted any of the healers in LA, and Swamiji was in LA. They needn't have contacted me, and I'm in San Diego, and there's no reason for anybody to contact me. But it was really amazing the way he works and the way he proved it to us that, you know, he is with you. So when he says he is with you, he really means it. And we're really thankful to you, Swamiji, for moving to us and being with us.
What do you have to say to that?
When divine wants, it does. Many people come and even ask me, Swamiji, you gave me darshan. I saw you in the dream. I saw you in my house. I felt you were not that in a vague way. I could very clearly see you were standing in my house when I did my aarti, and I could very clearly, not only, you see, there was one lady, she saw my darshan, she just wanted to check whether really it is true or not, and then she pulled the cloth. She says, I just pulled the cloth and saw, I could feel some the cloth in my hand. So she came and reported to me, I saw it, Swamiji. You see, there are two layers in me. The ordinary mind, a small layer which I am using to relate, to move this body. There is another layer which is the eternal energy, the enlightened energy. With that energy, you cannot handle this body. In that energy, I am everything. So from there, I just come down to a step to handle this body. That energy uses this form to help you. But wherever you get the darshan of me, I can really get it back. I can really tell what has happened at that time, or what has been given to you at that time, or what has happened between us, or what way you pray, or how intensely you are meditating. These things can be really brought, and I can tell. But giving darshan, only your intensity. That does a major play. It is not that for somebody I wanted to give and for somebody I don't give. It is the energy. Whenever you are intense, you see it. Immediately you see, I'll be there, of course. And so many times, so many people seen the visions. And last time when I came to America, before that in India I declared. Actually, my coming to America was a very, very good joke. If you know the story, it was a good joke. He came for some marriage program, to attend marriage. They both came to my city center and they were talking. They called me, Swamiji, you should come to America. I said, let me meditate and tell. So I didn't say yes or anything. They went away for marriage. After July 4th, I had the 1 year course starting the ashram. We have 1 year course program in the ashram. Anybody who is above 18 can join the program. 1 year, food, clothing, syllabus, books, all these things are free. Above 18, male or female can join. 1 year they can spend, learn all the spiritual things, a life of spirituality, all the spiritual tradition, the philosophy, yoga, basic naturopathy, healing science, all those things they can learn. 1 year chance, the possibility for them to transform their life. So the course is being started on that day. When I finished that course, I was in the very deep ecstasy for more than 6-7 hours. When I came down, the first word I told is, tell I am coming to America. The first word, they asked me, Swamiji, how to arrange? When will we go? That and all I don't know. Before the Guru Payarchi. Guru Payarchi means the Guru's change. I'll be there in America. I just told. They asked me, Swamiji, what is Guru is changing July 28th. July 4th I'm declaring. July 4th evening I'm telling.
Only 2 weeks.
July 4th evening I'm telling that I'll be going to America. July 28th Guru is changing.
No visa, nothing.
Only passport is there. They took the passport and gave it to the first to the basic inquiry. They said the passport photograph is without turban. And now he's having a hair and turban, nothing can be done. Do all reprocessing. Then somehow they did all the processing and it has reached the embassy. You know American embassy. And they gave 3 months interviews only after September 11. Because that is the time, September 11, they said only after September 11 interviews. Then the news reached me, that and all. I told, I do not know all those things. I know only one thing. Before Guru's change, Guru is changing from Kanya Rasi to Sima Rasi. The India's energy is Kanya and America is Sima. Oh, no. So before Guru's change, I am going to go. That much only I know. I do not know all the other things. And they said, what is this, Swamiji? You are telling the same thing. Then they finally, they somehow got this way and that way. Interview came on July 17th. I think July 17th interview. They called me and I went to the interview and it was a very big joke. The whole interview was, that man asked, what for you want to go to America? I told that they wanted me to come and preach meditation. So that is the reason I want to go to America. What? You look so young, what will you teach? You look so young, what will you teach? I really thought it's right. What he asked is right. And then I gave him one cassette, audio cassette, Mahamantra cassette. If you have time, you can listen. If you feel that I can teach something, then you decide. Otherwise, there is no problem. I just told him thank you. And I was about to leave. By the time before I leave, he put that rejected seal and threw the passport out. And then after putting the seal, he's telling me, if you go, this looks like a religious dress. That I was with this same color. This looks like a religious dress. If you change to other clothes, people may listen to you. There is a possibility for you going there. Something like that he said. I just turned and told, give me 1 week visa, I'll change your people's clothes. Actually, till that moment, I was very cool and calm. I didn't react. When he told about the cloth, you see, it's something like a, what to say, the respect to this dress. This is the dress where thousands and thousands of people have become enlightened by using this dress. So finally, you see, no, nothing can be done when the divine wants something to be done. Nothing can be done. I heard only one thing, the officer who rejected the visa, he heard that cassette afterwards. He heard that Mahamantra cassette. Maybe what has happened, we do not know.